let's talk about D-Day first, because just the whole idea of having these two fantastic actors and then not having them anymore, you know, in these past 3 months, it's been such a loss. I mean, we knew that they were both ill, but still, you know, I mean, how do you cope with that? Because your memories of both of them working together must be so strong and so powerful. Must be revisiting those days.
No, absolutely. I mean, those 3 or 4 days when it all happened one after the other, you know, actually the day before Irfan passed away, Sudhir bhai called me up and told me, listen, I've just found out that it's very tough, and he's already in the hospital. He's been there for some time, and I'm not being able to get through to him. Do you think that you can figure out? I said that, you know, I told him that the only person obviously will be speaking with him right now would be Tishu and Vishal. You know, one of them you should speak with, and we should try and figure out something. We couldn't. Unfortunately, he passed away before any of us could speak with him. I finally managed to send a message to Sutapa and finally, but the thing is, in that evening, Kaveri, I sent a message. Arjun called me up. So Arjun Rampal called me up and said, hey, what's happened? I can't believe this and whatever. And I spoke to Arjun and I spoke to Uma. And I just felt that, you know, maybe I should speak to Chintuji.
Right.
So I picked up the phone and I called him up. And he didn't answer. Ooh. So I sent him a message saying that, Chintuji, I don't know. I heard that you are not feeling too well, but I just wanted to tell you that, you know, Irfan is no more, etc.
Right.
And I'll come and see you next week.
Right.
Next day he was gone.
God. That's so terrible, no?
Yeah, I mean, it was shocking that to imagine that your unread message was possibly on his phone when he was, you know, in the hospital at that time. And it was just with Irfan, Irfan was a huge, was the star who had just done Life of Pi with Ang Lee,
right,
and just come to my set. So for me, he was very intimidating.
Yeah.
I didn't, I actually had to get Anurag Kashyap and Sudhir Mishra to convince Irfan to do D-Day.
Really?
But because he kept saying that tum, jo Ritesh aur tune ye script likha hai, par tu ultimately yaar tu mujhe Brooklyn Bridge pe khada kar dega, bolega ki ye gana kar.
With your arms.
He said, tu kalo na tune banaye, tu kaise banayega ye picture, tu bol raha hai handheld, tu bol raha hai ye, tu bol raha hai ye sab, tu kaise karega ye sab. So he had no idea that I had been involved in the writing with Raj Ki Subhani. So actually I had to get both Sudhir and Anurag. I remember that my final meeting before Irfan said yes was when Irfan had come to see the edit of Gangs of Wasseypur in Anurag's office.
Oh.
And while Anurag was basically, had just finished, yes, it's finished watching, and I think we accosted Irfan over there, because I entered and he said, ye tu yahan pe kya kar raha hai, ye kya pe kya kar raha hai, you know. And then I had to convince him to do the film. With Rishi sir, it wasn't that, because I had done Patiala House with him. We had become very, very close. I was his neighbor, because I stayed a building away from him in Pali Hill.
Okay.
Every day 8 o'clock, when he did not have his own people visiting him for a drink, he would say, you have to come across, sit down with me, boy.
Yeah.
And after the third drink, when he started calling me boy, I knew that I had to go home.
But he was a fantastic person, wasn't he? Both of them were just amazing. You became friends with Irfan after D-Day, though, didn't you?
Yes, I did. I mean, while making the film, I think he understood that. Because he, you know, finally, Kaveri, what I am today as a filmmaker is because of Irfan.
Right.
As an assistant director, you land up with a lot of notes.
Yeah.
And you want to look prepared.
Right.
You know, especially with the actor, and you want to be come across. And this was Irfan Khan, and I mean, I was at this point trying to prove to everybody that I can actually make this film. So I'd come with a lot of notes, and I said, okay, I'll do this, and then, you know, from the next line we'll take from this part, and we'll do this, and then, sir, I'll cut to a wide, I'll do this. And he said, listen, hello. You have a very good DOP in Tushar, right? You've written some very wonderful lines. Just sit at the monitor and see, na. leave the acting to me, let Tushar capture, and uske baad tu dekh lete wo kya mil raha hai, kya nahi mil raha hai, you know.
Yeah.
And so it just became so spontaneous.
Right.
You know, that I just chose not to then. So even today, when my DOPs come to me and say, what are we going to be shooting, sir? I said, listen, I'll tell you.
Yeah.
I don't know right now. And I reached the set, I'll tell you what we are going to be shooting.
Right. With how was it with Rishi?
You know, the thing is that he's like a child, right? And so he was, again, coming onto a set, and he used to see all the new equipment, and he would be saying that, wow, we can move the camera like this, and we can do this. But even with Rishi, I went to cast him in the role of Nasir Saab, which is for the head of Raw.
Right. You know?
And I happened to bring it up on the second drink.
Right.
And he fired me and said, I'm not John Voight. I'm not bloody Gene Hackman. You know? I'm not a character actor. I'm a star. You need to give me a star role. You know. So I said, okay, forget it. You don't do this film. Don't do this film. We'll do the next one.
Right.
And I went home, and that day actually he showed me a clip of the Rauf Lala in Agnipath.
Agnipath. Oh God, what a performance! Oof.
Yeah. So he showed it to me, and I went home, and I didn't sleep in the night. I called him up in the morning. He was sleeping. I had to wake him up, and I said, you know, you play Daud.
Right. Wow.
He started laughing. He said, well, itna hi pagal nahi. Don't be so desperate to have me in your film. Yeah. I said, no, let's do a look test. Nah. Let's do a look test. I'm convinced. If you are not convinced, let's do a look test.
Right.
So the minute he put on the mustache, and the minute he had put on the patch, you know, and he wore the costume, you know, and he walked into that floor number 4 of Mehboob Studio, he was already the character.
Right.
And he said, okay, give me a photograph. I said, you cannot send it to everybody. He sent it to the whole world. You know?
But how was the relationship between the two of them, Rishi and Irfan? Did they have a friendship or relationship?
So they didn't actually have to shoot together the last 6 days or the last 7 days of the shoot, because actually Irfan's track was very different from Rishi sir's track. And so they didn't have to shoot in the beginning of the film also, when they are in the Bhanja's wedding. He doesn't get, he gets, so they had the beginning, they had about 3-4 days of action, and then they had a large chunk of 6 or 7 days, which was in the farmhouse, and when they finally managed to capture him. If you know Rishi sir, he had already meeting Irfan, he said, so I'm going to see how good you are. Everybody's saying that you are fantastic. Everybody's saying you're this great actor.
Yeah.
You know, let's see this thing. And Irfan doesn't like to stick to cues. He likes to keep, he likes to keep changing things around, right? He's so Rishi sir, he should come and say, usko bolte the bachche batane ke liye ki kahan end karne wala hai. Take over from there. But they were then after that they were a house on fire, because they loved the outdoors. They love old music. Irfan knows all of the Raj Kapoor songs.
Wow.
Which is a great thing for
Rishi.
They love Jungli Chicken.
Okay.
Irfan, see, the one thing I miss most about Irfan, I mean, which I was telling even my wife, and every year the mangoes would come from his farm.
Oh.
Every year, irrespective, he would send a case of mangoes saying that, okay, this is what has happened or whatever. You know, so Irfan was a Sufi, right? He didn't want to go back to the hotel. So he told Rishi sir, why are you going back, sir? Live, we'll sleep under the stars.
Yeah.
I'll give you jungly chicken. So he made him stay back in the run of Kutch one day.
Wow.
You know, then it was quite good. I mean,
you really do miss both of them. You still speak of them in the present tense. It's so nice.
Yeah, I mean, D-Day is a life changing event for me.
Yeah.
You know, so I may not remember a lot of things, but I remember everything about D-Day.
Right.
It just changed everything for me.
Yeah. In what way? The way you made films.
It gave me a second chance. I mean, I remember the first person who saw the film was Karan, and we had a small screening for him. There was the light box used to be there at that time, and we had a small screening for him. Everybody else was going to watch it at 6 o'clock, and I told him, you come at 3 o'clock and watch it, because I want you to watch it by yourself. Because if you want to fire me, then fire me without anybody else being around. and he didn't come out. So the film got over and he didn't come out for some like 5 or 10 minutes. And my sister went in first. They know each other also, and she went in first. And then she came out. She said, "Okay, come. He wants to call. He's calling." I said, "Okay, lag gayi." You know. And he said that all the red lines on your report card have been wiped off with this one film.
Yeah.
Said, this film is something else. You know? I said, so yeah, so for me, Kaveri, I understand before D-Day, nobody thought, I mean, everybody had written me off. I mean, you know, for me to get this particular cast and then suddenly to make the film this the way I, it also, there was nothing holding me back, right? I was not thinking about people, actors' images. This particular, I can't do this with this particular character because this actor is playing this character. So therefore, his fan base will get upset about certain things. Like, all those things were not there. You know, I was just following a vision and a script. I was just following that. Yeah. And a great script by Ritesh.